Are you receiving the error the dependency service R group failed to start? Well, no fear. In this video, we will look at some troubleshooting steps you can try to fix the problem. As always, for a more in-depth look at the topic, check out the article in the description. First off, let's look at what the error means. Simply put, it means that a related service is not running or has failed to start. If you want to find a list of dependencies of a Windows service, then open Services, then select the service in question. Right-click on it and go to Properties. Select Dependencies. And here you can see a list of the services which this service depends on and which services depend on this service. Let's look at some common troubleshooting steps. We can add Localservice and Networkservice to the admin group. To do this, we first need to open the command prompt as an administrator. Then type in net local group administrators local service space slash add and hit enter. Then type in net local group administrators network service space slash add and hit enter. After that, type in exit, restart your system, and see if the problem is resolved. After that, we can also change the Windows PC option to normal startup. If you recently put your PC in selective startup or diagnostic startup, you might not have switched it back. Let's try doing that. Press the Windows key and R to open the run box. Type in msconfig and click OK. In the General tab, make sure that Normal Startup is selected. If not selected, then click Apply and OK. Restart your system and see if that corrects the problem. We can also check the status of network-related services. Open the Services Manager again, and we want to check a few services and see if they are configured right. Application Layer Gateway Service, Manual, Network Connections, Startup type as manual, network location awareness, manual, plug and play, manual, remote access auto connection manager, manual, remote procedure call RPC. It should be set to automatic. And finally, telephony should be set to manual. Make any of the changes you need, then restart your system and see if that helps. There may also be service-specific problems. In the linked article, we go into more depth on each one of those.
For more helpful articles to help you maximize your Windows experience, go to our website, thewindowsclub.com. Do not forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel, where we are always adding new content aimed at making you the master of your digital house. Thanks for watching and have a great day.